This is blog three. What the blog today is about is my experience going back to school as an adult, going back to college. And being in college already as an adult is kind of an adjustment in itself and definitely a change, a big change, but how much more going as a foreign student. So, but first let's discuss about the advantages of going to school at my age. I went back to school last year at the age of 33, and one of the biggest things that I had to adjust to was going back to school with kids half my age. And when I say kids half my age, I really mean they're 15, 16 years old. They are half my age. If I was a teenage mother, I could have had one of them as my children. That's basically how big of an age gap it is. And it's not like if I was going back to school in the States, where I'd be going to school with 18, 19 year olds in my freshman class. I am literally always the oldest in class. I think I am pretty much the eldest student in the entire university. That's what it feels like. Anyway, I have yet to meet anybody who was in their 30s. So, and it's definitely a disadvantage. And also the fact that most of the teachers are either my age, younger than me, and only just slightly older than me. So it's kind of it's a definite adjustment to deal with. And that is basically one of my biggest problems right now, is actually throughout the whole entire year that I've had going back to school, is being treated like one of the kids by the teachers, by the staff, by the, you know, the adults' authority in school. A lot of times I get treated like I'm one of the other kids. And I get that, you know, I'm a student, so I'm getting treated like a student. But in a lot of ways, in the way they talk to the kids, you know, oh, you're still learning, you're still young, you still don't know anything. I'm like, whoa, hold on. Please do not include me in this kind of discussion, because I'm 33 and I have been working since I was 18 years old. 15 years of working experience in retail and offices. So it's a little frustrating, because it feels like I'm reverting back to my high school days of when we were treated like children, and now I have to deal with that again at my age. I have to be treated like I'm a child again, and it can be frustrating, because I'm like, come on, I'm an adult. Seriously, I've gone through all this stuff already. Must I go through it again? So that's part of the thing. And the third one is basically money. I worked full time. I was getting paid pretty decently, considering where, you know, being in San Antonio, cost of living was kind of low, so your dollar could be pretty much going a lot farther. And working for a hotel, a hospitality company, I was able to have really great benefits, and I was able to take advantage of the benefits of going to any of their hotels around the world for free 12 nights at a time per year. And I definitely took advantage of that, and I love traveling, so that was perfect for me. So all I had to do was save up for a plane ticket and food and other costs, and it was perfect. And yes, I had a lot of credit card debt or whatever, but I still got to buy a lot of things that I really, really wanted. If I wanted really something, then I can go get it. And like, I saved up really hard for my camera, my baby, and then it got stolen last year, and it really pained me because being a full-time student, I am not working. My savings is pretty much almost gone. I mean, I have a little bit, but that's pretty much over. And most of it got spent moving here and also the cost of getting everything ready in the house because it was really old and there was really nothing here. And then paying for my tuition. So now I'm relying on my parents, my mom and my dad in helping, especially my mom. My mom is helping like a lot. And to have to be financially having to worry so much more about the money that I'm spending because it's not mine, I'm borrowing money from my parents. So, and my dad had to buy me a new camera to replace the camera that was taken. And so it almost feels like it's not really my camera. And I feel even more paranoid about this camera than I ever was with the camera that I lost. And so those are the things that's frustrating. You know, I can't just do whatever what I want or just spend whatever I want. I mean, not like I really did that back home, but I mean, you get it, that it's your money and you get to go and spend it and be a little bit frivolous every once in a while and treat yourself and things like that. So that's definitely one thing that I miss. I miss having that money coming in and being a full-time student, it gets a little frustrating and having a lot of the kids end up getting more of an allowance than me and having to actually say I have an allowance is it kind of hurts my pride at this point. And but I'm very thankful that my parents are willing to help me to be able to go back to school full time. And the fact that school is a lot cheaper here than in the States definitely helps. So another one is my memory. And I have like a cue card so I can keep my train of thought in focus because my memory is quite awful. Due to health issues or something, through the years, my memory has deteriorated quite immensely. My short-term memory pretty much is like non-existent, and my long-term memory is kind of like passable for the most part. And then I remember like random stupid stuff that is like of no importance. So, I mean, it's so bad that I actually write people's names down that I should already have memorized by now. That I would have already memorized by now if my memory was anything like how it was when I was younger. And the fact that I have to study so much more and try all these other different studying habits and studying methods, there's definitely no procrastination, and I definitely cannot study or treat education like I did when I was in school because otherwise I would fail. There is just no way I can get away with doing things last minute and things like that, and it's very difficult for me, especially when we are doing group and a lot of them procrastinate and they don't take things, some of them don't take things seriously and some of them don't contribute like they should. So it gets me a little frustrated because I like to get things done and as soon as possible, and I like to get things equal because I don't like anyone getting a grade that they didn't work for. And that's like one of my biggest pet peeves. And so yeah, it's definitely, those are some of the difficulties of going back to school. And then the whole, you know, work mentality versus school mentality is quite a different thing. In work, you have this regular thing going on, and you have a routine and you pretty much already know what you're going to do, so you can pretty much do it like without really thinking and trying that hard. And I mean, it's not like it's not hard work, it's just that it's a different type of mindset. And while in school, you can't clock out and you can't just like, oh, okay, whatever, I'll just get this done. It's all constant new thing, you're constantly learning. And as my memory has deteriorated, all the stuff that I learned in school is gone. And pretty much most of the stuff I'm learning is brand new to me. It feels brand new. And in fact, for a lot of the kids, they're at better positions than me in learning. And it's really difficult. And so I have to prioritize, and I have very little social life. And speaking of social life, it's pretty much non-existent, because being in foreign school and being among a lot of kids, it's not that I haven't made friends or whatever, but their interests and a lot of their discussions are quite different than mine. And all my close friends, of course, are back home. So I spend a lot of times late at night chatting with my friends back home, but it's very hard to find friends, at least somewhere close to my age, mingling with adults, because I'm always at school, and I don't get to really mingle with people my age outside of school, and it's very hard to become friends with, you know, your teachers and the staff members at school. It's very kind of awkward. So those are the challenges that I've been meeting as a college student at my age. And another thing, I feel like I'm forgetting something. Ah, yes. Everybody looks to me for the answer or for the leadership or for leadership. Who's going to be the head of the group? A lot of times they pick me. Who's going to get this done? It's usually me. Who's going to be more responsible? It's usually me. And I mean, I don't mind doing it, and I like a little bit of the control. I can't, you know, I'm going to be honest, I like the control of being the leader and taking the helm. But it gets frustrating every once in a while because I feel kind of like I'm, in a way, babysitting sometimes, that I'm constantly having to push. And so it gets a little frustrating and it feels like extra work. And so sometimes I just want to be able to sit back and relax and do my work and my thing and not have to worry about leading anybody. I mean, yeah, leading is great and it's great for my resume for sure. Every once in a while, I like to be as chill as everybody else. Dang it. So, yeah, these are the disadvantages of going back to school. They expect you to know more, they have higher expectations for you, and they don't seem to understand. Dude, I haven't been in school for 15 years. All that stuff that I learned, that's gone. You know, I mean, sure, I've learned a lot through life experience and things like that, and I can use that, but it's quite a different thing. So I always feel a little a disarray and awkward, and so it's definitely been an adjustment, and it's always going to be a slight adjustment in different things, and I just have to kind of deal with it. And I have, and I've managed to get through it, surprisingly enough. Determination, will, willpower, and the drive and ambition that I need to finish school, and I want to be successful in doing it, and I want to make myself proud. It's not for anybody else, but for me. So I guess that's it. The next video will be about the advantages of going to school, back to school at my age. So I will see you then.